In part 3 of our lesson on the unit circle and circular functions, you're going to learn about estimating circular function values using a graph of the unit circle. In this example, we're being asked to draw an arrow on the unit circle graph to indicate how you estimate each value. So this first circular function is the cosine of 0.4. Remember, this is S equals 0.4. And when we look on the unit circle, S is the variable that represents arc length. So S is going around the circle. So we travel along the arc length until we get to 0.4. which is right here. Now, because this is asking us for the cosine of 0.4, we know that's going to come from the x value. So from this point, S is equal to 0.4, we need to get the x value, and that's what this is talking about when it says draw an arrow to indicate how you estimate. We're going to draw an arrow from here down to the x value. And that looks like it's just a little bit more than 0.9. So maybe we'll guess 0.92. So we're going to estimate that the cosine of 0.4 is about 0.92. In this next problem, we're asked to find the sine of 3.4. So again, make sure you're keeping track of what variables you have. This means that S is equal to 3.4, and it's asking us to find the sine, so we're going to have to look at the y value there. So we travel around the arc length of the circle until we get to 3.4. That's what we have to do here. Now we notice that these marks here from 3 to 4, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 marks. That means each mark is 0.2. So if this is 3, then this is going to be 3.2. This would be 3.4. So at S equals 3.4, we have to find the sine of 3.4, which means get the y value. So if we're at this point right here, we would draw an arrow to the y value, and we would probably estimate that that is about negative 0.25. because it's about halfway between negative 0.2 and negative 0.3. So this is negative 0.25. All right, you give this one a try and then restart the video when you're ready to check. This one's asking us to find the cosine of 5.2. We know that means S is 5.2. So going around the arc length, 2, 3, 4, here's 5. So the next tick mark would be 5.2. And because it's asking us to find the cosine of 5.2, we know that's going to come from the x value. So starting at S equals 5.2, we draw our arrow up here to get the x value. And that looks like it's roughly around the middle, maybe slightly under. Maybe we think that's about 0.44. If you said 0.45, that would be fine. If you said 0.43, that would be fine. If you said 0.49, that wouldn't be fine because that would be way over here. So we're estimating about 0.44. Next, we're asked to find the smallest positive angle whose sine is negative 0.7. So this time we know the value of the sine. What we don't know is S. So this problem is saying the sine of S is equal to negative 0.7. So we know that means that's the y value. The y value is going to be negative 0.7. So coming over here on the unit circle graph, that would be right here where y is negative 0.7. Now it's asking us to find the smallest angle. We know if we go to quadrant 3 or quadrant 4 of those two choices, quadrant 3 is going to be smaller. So starting at the y value of negative 0.7, we go out to the circle and we have to estimate the value of S here. Now we know this is 4. We know this would be 3.8. So this mark right here, this looks like it's more than halfway. So this seems like it would be more than 3.9. 3.9 would be at about the halfway mark, exactly halfway between 3.8 and 4. So we're a little bit more than that. So really almost anything you would say, if you said 3.92 or 3.93 or 3.94, any of those values would be about the same. So S, we're estimating, is approximately 3.93, say. All right, so pause the video and you try this next one. So here we have to find the smallest positive angle whose cosine is negative 0.6. So we're given that the cosine of S is equal to negative 0.6. So we know that that is our x value. So we go to the graph where the x value would be negative 0.6, which is right here. We know that means the angle could be in quadrant 2 or quadrant 3. The smaller angle is going to be in quadrant 2. So we draw our arrow up to the quadrant 2 angle. And we can see that the dotted line goes right to this tick mark. If this is 2, then we know that this is 2.2. So we know we're saying that S is going to be approximately 2.2. And of course, S and theta are going to have the same value. So in each of these cases, we solved for S. Now the problem asks us about the angle, but remember that on the unit circle, you know that S and theta have the same value. So if we know that S is equal to 3.93, then that means that's what theta is. And in this one, S was approximately 2.2, so we know that's going to be what theta is. And just a reminder that S is the length of the arc, so it's a physical distance, so this would be 2.2 miles, or 2.2 feet, or 2.2 inches. Where theta is in radians. So if S is 2.2 inches, theta is 2.2 radians.